Captain's log supplemental. A Garidian warbird has violated the neutral zone in pursuit of a scout ship. The fugitives may be seeking political asylum, but as yet we have been unable to confirm their intentions.
And welcome to a brand new Let's Play, playing Star Trek The Next Generation, A Final Unity, which was developed by Spectrum Holobyte and published by Microprose in the year 1995. Pretty impressive for 1995, believe it or not. And this is continuing my celebration of the 50th anniversary of Star Trek here in 2016, at least. I have played a few other games. A few years back, I played Star Trek Borg and Star Trek Klingon. Those are FMV games for Windows 95 and or 98. And recently, I played the 25th anniversary and Judgment Rights, both published by Interplay in, I believe, 92 and 93, if I have it right. And those were a lot of fun. Those were DOS games, and this is a little more advanced, a little more, you see, can see the evolution. I like the way the intro... He starts looking around, because I'm not doing anything. Was he winking at him? Give him the eye. Got distracted. Yeah, we had the teaser intro, and the theme song, just like in the show. Pretty awesome. Of course, these were computer-generated graphics, not models from the show. It was a different, you know, completely different intro, but really closely matches the original show. A little personal note to Jeroen. Here's your game, and, well, when I reply to your comments, I think you don't get notifications, so you're going to have to manually check for them. I always reply, you know, even if it's just something like cool or thanks or something, I always reply, so, and that goes for anybody. I don't get notifications of your comments, Jeroen. I have to manually go into my, I think it's Creator Studio, they call it, and look at all the comments there. For some reason, I do not get emails for them. Sometimes the YouTube app will send me, you know, a notification, you know, on my phone. So sometimes that works. That's thing. But anyway, down... I don't know. I guess I'm gonna put it around here. Links to the other games that I've played. So... And next, after this, will be Star Trek The Next Generation Echoes from the Past, which is a Sega Genesis or Mega Drive game. And this came out on CD-ROM and features the original cast. Just about everybody, or almost everybody, did voices from the original cast. So pretty awesome. And the combat in this game, I do not know.
Sensors are detecting an energy buildup within the scout ship. I believe they have activated a self-destruct mechanism.
Can you beam the scout ship crew aboard?
We cannot establish a transporter lock. There is too much interference from the Warbird's tractor beam. I estimate that the scout ship will self-destruct in approximately 1 minute.
All right, we can get thoughts of everybody around here.
Any insights, Counselor?
I don't know if this is really going to happen exactly 1 minute real time, though.
The Garidian captain is torn about something, as if she were faced with a difficult dilemma.
She has violated the neutral zone.
It's more than that. I think she has a personal stake in this matter.
Mr. Worf, your analysis.
The Garidian warbird is similar to the Romulan Dideridex class. It is less maneuverable than the Enterprise, but it has slightly more firepower.
We'd both take a beating if it came down to a fight.
Our records identify the warbird as the Asirim, commanded by Captain Pintara. Starfleet intelligence rates her as a capable but unimaginative tactician.
Yeah. Captain Pintara, she really rocks out.
Mr. Data, do you have any suggestions?
As long as the warbird maintains a tractor beam on the scout ship, we cannot beam its crew aboard. However, if we maneuvered the Enterprise between the ships, we could temporarily disrupt the tractor beam.
Yeah, it's always a valid thing, and that's one way. I have played, like, basically past this encounter, and the rest is going to be completely blind.
We will have to drop our shields to use the transporter.
I'm not willing to take that risk.
Kind of like this option.
What do you think, Number One?
The Gridians respect strength. If we show any sign of weakness, it might just encourage them to fight.
What do you suggest?
Maybe we can use our phasers until they listen to reason.
Yeah, why the hell not?
Let's give it a try. Lock phasers on the Warbird, 10% power. Fire.
Be cool little cutscenes.
Bird is hailing us.
Oh god. I don't know, that transition is dodgy, isn't it? On screen.
On screen.
Federation Starship. This is an internal Gridian matter. You've been warned not to interfere.
Now, these are not Romulans. These are Gridians. They're just using Romulan ships. As we saw in the intro, they have a close relationship with the Romulans. They trade technology and stuff like that. Surely we can resolve this matter without recourse to further violence. They appreciate, like Worf, not Worf, Riker said, they appreciate shows of strength, so this can be seen as weak, saying that. Your presence here gives me every right to interfere. Why have you violated the neutral zone? You will leave Federation space at once or face the consequences. You have committed an act of war by crossing the neutral zone. Surrender your ship immediately. They're not going to surrender the ship. I'm going to take this. Why have you violated the neutral zone?
Your presence here gives me every right to interfere. Why have you violated the neutral zone?
Captain, the Warbird has disengaged its tractor beam. They are locking their disruptors on us.
Oops.
Transporter room, lock on and energize.
Okay, automatically locking on and energizing the other smaller craft.
We will have to drop our shields to use the transporter.
Well, the members of the craft, not the craft itself. We'll have to take that risk.
We'll have to take that risk.
The crew of the scout ship has been beamed aboard.
Just like that.
Captain, you are harboring dangerous criminals. I demand that you transfer them to my custody immediately.
Hmm. I like her voice. Interesting. They are now guests upon my ship. If you return to Gridian space immediately, I will overlook your violation of the neutral zone. I don't know. I don't think these guys were ever in the series, or so Gridians are just made up for the game. I kind of feel like looking that up, actually. Whatever crimes they may have committed, you had no right to pursue them across the neutral zone. Before this discussion goes any further, I want to know why, who these people are and why you have pursued them across the neutral zone. Yeah. Information. Our Gridian guests were rescued in Federation space. Any extradition will have to proceed along normal diplomatic channels. I want information. Who these people are, why you have pursued them.
Before this discussion goes any further, I want to know who these people are and why you have pursued them across the neutral zone.
They are traitors and killers. My orders are to take them back to Garrod to stand trial for murder and sedition.
Whatever crimes they may have committed, you had no right to pursue them across the neutral zone.
Yes, one of the other options.
I was sent to bring these criminals back dead or alive, and I will carry out my orders even if it means destroying your ship.
Oh my.
A Gridian ship is on sensors.
Targeting
the shields
Gridian.
Are
Mr. Wolf,
holding.
You have
are
being
Worf.
Fire.
The ship is close.
You and I are not finished, Picard. I promised you that.
Now that was very quick. We probably have to slow down the CPU cycles, but doing that messes with the sound and the video from, well, the ISO file that I made. So I'm not sure how we're going to get by that in the future. I don't know if Worf can help us every time.
We have been hit. The Gridian ship has been destroyed.
Good.
Captain, our new arrivals are requesting to speak with you. Their names are Lucana, Avakar, and Tabak.
What are your orders, Captain?
I'm going to consider the situation. I'm not going to go there first.
I should like to consider the situation a bit further.
Now, there's a way to get them through. Yeah, kind of. Yeah. I'm going to show you guys the way to get past this without combat. Okay, now I've taken all the same actions. I fired on her with the phasers and all that. You will leave Federation space at once or face the consequences, perhaps.
You will leave Federation space at once or face the consequences.
Captain, the Warbird has disengaged its tractor beam. They are locking their disruptors on us.
Transporter room, lock on and energize.
We will have to drop our shields to use the transporter.
We'll have to take that risk.
The crew of the scout ship has been beamed aboard.
Those people you have apprehended are dangerous criminals.
They are now guests aboard my ship, etc.
They are now guests aboard my ship. If you return to Garidian space immediately, I will overlook your violation of the neutral zone.
Very well. You have won this time, Captain. But I promise you, there will be a next time.
The Warbird is heading back toward Garidian space. They are activating their cloaking device.
Right, so this is how you get by without having to even enter combat. Negotiation, and diplomacy, which Picard is very good at.
Captain, our new arrivals are requesting to speak with you.
What are your orders, Captain?
I should like to consider the situation a bit further.
Okay. Now you can still talk to everybody.
Counselor, do you have any thoughts?
I'm sorry, Captain, but I don't have any suggestions right now.
Mr. Worf, your analysis.
Captain, we should check our orders from Starfleet.
We can do that.
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain, I don't have any suggestions right now.
Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest we contact Starfleet, Captain.
They really want us to contact Starfleet. Now, here... You can talk to these people in the conference room, I think it is. This goes to the transporter room, engineering, and holodeck. If I click here, which is, I don't know, Worf's leg or something, you can get to tactical. This is the...
Primary core access enabled.
Computer.
Systems online.
We got the voice of Major Barrett. Again, awesome. And they have all these entries. I'm probably going to devote a separate... video for all this stuff. Really excellent music in that, the computer, as it is. So also, if you click, it's his comm badge. You can talk to Starfleet.
Admiral Williams here. What can I do for you, Captain?
I'd like to confirm our current orders.
Of course. Starfleet Command is still considering the options. While we review the situation, the Enterprise is to remain on patrol.
What's your assessment? Now this reminds me of the first two games, 25th Anniversary and Judgment Rites. At the end of every mission, well, there was like separate episodes within the game, you would have a... Starfleet would rate you on your performance during that mission.
What's your assessment of our recent performance?
The Enterprise's presence in this region has set a lot of minds at ease, but I'm still concerned about the Romulan activity in the area. Look sharp, Captain.
Kind of wondering if Starfleet's going to be as much of a pain in the butt as in those two games.
What is the current situation, Admiral? Is there anything in particular we should be aware of?
Actually, things are relatively quiet right now. The only cause for concern is all the Romulan activity in the area.
And this is just your exit. Picard out.
Picard out.
Now, before we talk to our guests, I just want to show you guys the holodeck. Now here we've got the prologue and the title sequence, which you saw in my intro video, episode 1. Warning the Garidian Warbird, which is...
acknowledged.
Curious. Oh, it's just a video of us firing on them. Short but sweet. Now this, as far as I know, you can only see this video within the holodeck, so that's why I'm gonna play it now.
Acknowledged.
Welcome aboard, Captain. The bridge is the command and control center of the Starship Enterprise. Many of the ship's functions can be controlled from this location. The communications station is used to open a channel to a planet, ship, or Starfleet command. The main function of the op station is to view records in the ship's computer. At the op station, the computer can look up information on spacecraft, celestial bodies, and general history. An analysis of the current mission can also be viewed. The Khan is the helm of the Enterprise. At the Khan, a course and speed are plotted for a destination planet. Regional planetary information can also be selected and displayed. The conference lounge is a meeting room for greeting visitors.
About to say something else there, but she got cut off.
The tactical station is the area for defending the Enterprise in case of attack. The tactical station controls offensive and defensive maneuvers, phaser fire, and the launch and dispersal of photon torpedoes. Control of this station can be delegated to Lieutenant Worf. The turbo lift provides access to other parts of the ship, including engineering, the holodeck, and the transporter room. In engineering, the ship's power levels are adjusted, and repairs of damaged systems are conducted. Control of this station can be delegated to Lieutenant Commander LaForge. The holodeck is the area to review mission films previously stored in the ship's library.
Which is what we were doing.
The transporter room is the location for assembling an away team. To be successful, an away team must have a proper blend of talents for the mission at hand. Before beam down, the away team must be equipped with appropriate gear for the mission. When the away team is ready to go, the mission will then commence.
And that's that. I'll just show you my settings really quick. Sound levels I have down enough so that you can hear me. Text is on. Difficulty is actually Lieutenant. We also have Captain and Ensign. The only difference I think there is between these is that in Captain, you select for your away missions what crew members and what equipment you're going to be taking. Ensign, it's done automatically for you. Lieutenant, it's just done as automatically as well, but you can change it if you want. So, other than that, as far as what I can see, there's no other difference. So, and the other thing is if you hit here, which is the con, which for some reason nobody's sitting at, you can see all different sectors. You can lane in a course, engage, disengage, display.
Inhabited space displayed. Star bases displayed.
And you can look on this plane, I guess it is. And this is just within a solar system. Really haven't messed with this. I've read through the manual, so I have a basic working understanding of this stuff. These are wormholes. This is an unstable binary star or something. I don't know what this is counting down. Okay, never mind. So let's talk to our visitors. Now we're entering blind territory for me. One at a time. Tabak.
Captain Picard. Can you help us contact a Vulcan archaeologist named Shaynok? He may possibly hold the key to the discovery of the Lawgiver's fifth scroll.
And why are you looking for that? What is this fifth scroll you mentioned?
What is this fifth scroll you mentioned?
Yeah, I might stop just reading it, because he says the same exact thing.
Let me give you a bit of background. Caridian society is a rigid structure consisting of two distinct classes, the patricians and the plebeians.
Too bad we don't actually go in the conference room and talk to them.
For the past 1,000 years, that structure has been governed by the laws derived from the four sacred scrolls. The first scroll outlines our code of honor. The second describes the relationship between the military and the government. The third defines the principles of our religion. And the fourth enumerates the privileges and responsibilities of the patrician class.
So the fifth has to do with that other class?
But you speak of another scroll.
According to legend, the Lawgiver also wrote a fifth scroll defining the rights and privileges of the plebeian class, which were not explained in the other scrolls.
Well, you know, the fifth scroll is Skyrim. Who is the Lawgiver?
Who is the Lawgiver?
His real name was Avatrunai, and he was the architect of Caridian society. His four scrolls became the cornerstone of our entire culture.
What makes you think Shaynok can help you?
What makes you think Shaynok can help you?
Or Shaynok?
My studies indicate that the followers ended up somewhere in what is now Federation space. But because our governments are not on friendly terms, I could never follow up on that research. But the Vulcan scholar Shaynok lives in the Federation and has made extensive studies of our history. I believe he may have vital information that will help us locate the followers.
If you'll excuse me, I have other duties to attend to. Perhaps we can talk again later.
Okay, so let's talk to Lucana.
Captain Picard, my name is Lucana. On behalf of the oppressed underclasses of Garad, I'd like to thank you for rescuing us.
Don't thank me too quickly. You have illegally entered Federation space, and this ship is not a haven for criminals.
I am not a criminal, Captain. I am only seeking justice for my people.
Very well. You may stay on board the Enterprise until we have sorted this matter out.
Do not dismiss me so quickly, Captain. The fate of all Garad is hanging in the balance.
Sounds important.
Why do you say that?
I am searching for the fifth scroll. It's the only way to give the plebeians the freedom they deserve.
We haven't found out who are these plebeians.
Who are the plebeians?
Plebeians?
They are the underclasses of Garad, forced by law to serve the patricians, their masters for the past 1,000 years.
We've heard it from the others. See why she's so interested, in her words.
Why are you so interested in this fifth scroll?
Finding the fifth scroll will free my people from tyranny because the scroll gives the rights to the plebeians, Garrett's lower classes. That's why the government doesn't dare let me succeed.
I'm not gonna choose that yet.
If you'll excuse me, I have other duties to attend to.
And Avakar.
I feel I should apologize for my mother's actions, Captain.
Oh. Was that your mother I was just speaking with?
Your mother?
Yes. My mother is Pentara, the captain of the Asirum. It was her vessel you confronted when she had my scout ship in her tractor beam.
Oh, that was his own mother. Interesting.
Why is your own mother trying to kill you?
She is only doing her duty. I know she doesn't want to kill me, but she is under orders to prevent Lucana from finding the Lawgiver's fifth scroll.
Why are you so interested in this fifth scroll?
Because I believe in Lucana's crusade. Even though I was born a patrician, Lucana has made me aware of the plebeian suffering. The fifth scroll would give them a more honorable place in Garidian society.
I sympathize with your cause, but I must inform you that the Federation will not take sides in Garrett's domestic politics.
Okay, he chose that option himself this time.
And we are not asking you to do so, Captain. When the time comes, we will fight that battle ourselves.
If you'll excuse me, I have other duties to attend to.
Well, let's see if any of them have anything to say about this fifth scroll and lawgiver.
Mr. Data, any suggestion?
I suggest we contact Starfleet.
Counselor, do you have any thoughts?
I'm sorry, Captain.
Nope.
Mr. Worf, your analysis.
Captain.
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain,
Starfleet?
Admiral Williams here. What can I do for you, Captain?
I'd like to confirm our current orders.
Of course. Starfleet Command is still considering the options. While we reviewed the situation, the...
Picard out.
Interesting. Already I don't know what to do. So, if I had hit view screen before, we had would have had a cool view of the Romulan warbird. But now it's just empty space. So we are in the Makiro sector. Now you can really get into this game as far as, you know, deciding how much power to go to warp and such. Tactical engineering. You can repair and you can set your power levels and everything. For the warp. Well, power, weapons, shields, sensors, even down to life support, computer cores, tractor beams. And Geordi can take care of things.
Miss LaForge, you have engineering.
Yes, sir.
You can hit self-destruct, at which point there's a neat little thing where they show that we've lost contact with the Enterprise and the game basically ends.
Mr. Worf, you have tactical.
Captain, I am honored.
So... I'm not sure what to do at this point. I guess we'll just head somewhere. I figured that, you know, this dialogue option was going to lead us into something. So already in the Makiro sector, I can head to Makiro Beta, which is a Class B3 star with an absolute magnitude of negative 2.0. It belongs to a binary star system with a Class M6 sister star of absolute magnitude 12.0. It possesses 5 planets, none of which is known to be inhabited. Okay, so now I understand we've got... This is basically all of known space, I believe. And this is the sector you're in, and this is the solar system you're in. Oh, cool. Makiro Beta 1, within its star's hot zone. Surface very hot, atmosphere contains heavy gases and metal vapors, no known life forms. Atmosphere tenuous, with few chemically active gases, no known life forms. Beta 2. Beta 3. Few chemically active gases, otherwise the same. Class 1 moon. 2B, 2A. All different moons. Atmosphere contains heavy gases and metal vapors, no known life forms. Now you can set your warp here. Or impulse. We're within a star system, so we'll use impulse.
Impulse engines unable to sustain current speed. Suggest using warp drive.
Warp drive? Are we not in this solar system? Okay, we're using warp then. Warp 8. Engage.
Engage.
I have no idea if anything's going to happen there or what we'll be expecting. So we're at warp 8.0 and we're 6.6 light years away. Headed to Makiru Beta 5. For some reason, we might just leave this sector. But let me get to take a look at the planet.
Helm, standard orbit.
Right. There's a planet. maybe we'll leave. They said we're supposed to be patrolling somewhere. I forget what they said. The sector's in the neutral zone. I don't want to go that. Tazarnus Nebula? Let's go to Sector Quasim, I guess? No idea where I'm supposed to be going, guys.
Engage.
But we can go there. Don't love that cinematic. Oh, we're far away. So I might speed this up.
Captain, we are receiving an emergency transmission from Simcoe 4.
Okay, not speeding up.
Simcoe 4? Isn't there a research center there?
Yes, sir. The work at Merton's orbital station focuses on power generation. The researchers there are among the best in the Federation.
On screen.
On screen. This is Captain Jean-Luc Picard of the Federation Starship Enterprise. How can we be of help?
Captain Picard, I am Deneb, Chancellor of Simcoe. We are in need of immediate assistance. Merton's orbital station has been attacked by an unknown vessel and does not answer our hails.
Hmm.
Attacked? But the station is a purely scientific facility.
Is the attacking vessel still present?
Yeah, that doesn't stop them, just because it's a scientific vessel or a station.
We do not know. Whoever or whatever they were, our sensors did not detect them.
Uncovering some kind of research that someone didn't want them to uncover? They wanted to steal some research, either one.
Perhaps it was a cloaked Romulan vessel.
I doubt the Romulans would venture this far into Federation territory. The risks are too great.
Captain, you must hurry. The attack has destabilized the station's experimental power core. We don't know how long we have until a core breach, but I can tell you the resulting energy release and radiation would be catastrophic.
Bada boom.
What about survivors? Did anyone get off the station?
We detected several escape pods, but we haven't recovered them yet. The pods we detected could hold only a few dozen. There are hundreds aboard the station, including families.
Set course for Simcoe 4. I hope it's not too late.
Thank you, Captain. I hope you arrive in time.
So do I.
We'll do our best. Picard out. Dr. Crusher.
Crusher here.
Doctor, we may shortly be taking on a large number of wounded, possibly hundreds.
Yeah. How many doctors and nurses and aides do you have?
How much time have I got?
Not enough, I'm afraid. Picard out.
Great answer.
Miss LaForge?
Yes, Captain.
We're en route to Merton's orbital station. They've been attacked, and they're going to need immediate assistance. See what you can find out about their experimental power core.
I'll see what I can dig up, but the Simconians do some advanced work. May take a while to figure it all out.
Then I suggest you work quickly. Millions of lives on the planet's surface may be at stake. I expect a full analysis of the situation and our options as soon as we're within sensor range.
Yes, sir.
Engage.
Automatically. Ooh, I can save. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. I'm going to save the game at this point, and yeah, see you in the next episode. Thanks for watching, and endure. And enduring, grow strong.